New York, 1955. American Museum of Natural History. It's become dangerous in the city. The Mafia is trying to seize power. But recently, a new force appeared here. A far more terrifying force. Over the last few days, five Mafia bosses have disappeared in mysterious circumstances. At the scenes of the disappearances, all they found was a strange liquid and a butterfly. But that's not what scared people. Children started to disappear in the city. All of them drew exactly the same butterflies before they disappeared. This forced the best detectives and journalists to take up the investigation. Good evening. I am Mr. Bishop. It was I who invited you here. I spoke with your editor, and he recommended you to me not only as a talented journalist, but as a good detective too. I imagine you've heard about the disappearing children and mafia bosses. I'd like to commission you for an article about this matter. I hope you won't refuse. There was a reason I arranged for this meeting in the museum. The last Mafia disappearance happened right here. The police have already left. Only the museum guard remains. He'll let you look at the scene. Right now, you'll have to excuse me. I have to go. We'll see each other again.
Good evening. Mr. Bishop told me you'd be coming. The policemen who were here before you didn't listen to me. I know a lot. I was here when it all happened. The lights went off, a green smoke appeared, and the man just melted into the air. This is the work of evil spirits, believe me. Now, excuse me. I have to do my rounds every half hour. I'll be back soon.
I've been waiting for you, but I didn't expect you to find the secret passage from the museum to the vault so quickly. You passed your first test with ease. I imagine you have many questions for me. First things first, let me introduce myself. My name is Lucas. I recently came out of a coma in which I spent the last 10 years. As soon as I could, I came back here, to the vaults of the Order of the White Stone. But when I got here, I discovered that none of my brethren were here, and hadn't been for a long time. So I need new assistance. Our organization has existed for hundreds of years. We collect and keep various artifacts, and carry out research on supernatural occurrences. This matter of the disappearing children and mafia bosses is one such occurrence. I think the children are still alive, but in danger. That's why we need to hurry. If you agree to work with me, bring me that strange swamp liquid from the museum. I'll try to study it.
Thank you.
Excellent. I'll go to the laboratory and study its content. And for you, I have a new task. I've learned that one of the missing gangsters is actually alive. I'm sure he's connected to this matter, and in order to prevent suspicion, he specially arranged for his own disappearance. He's hiding on his boat under the Brooklyn Bridge. The kidnapped children could be being held there too. We have an old system of tunnels. Using it, we can get to any point in the city. Here's a key for you. It's configured to take you straight to where you need to go. Be careful. The police won't help us. We can only rely on ourselves.
Thank you.
You turned out to be braver than I thought. What you saw confirms my suspicions. There's something supernatural behind all these events. You and I must find out what it is. I've studied the sample of the liquid from the last crime scene. It's ordinary water mixed with swamp algae. At first I thought this wouldn't lead anywhere, but then I remembered a strange turquoise-green fog mentioned in the newspapers. Some could even make out an apparition in this fog. The fog covered one of the banks of the Hudson, and a sample of the water there matched our sample perfectly. One of our underground tunnels leads there. I think you should check the place out.
Thank you. Tom Lawrence, I need to show these papers to Bishop. Maybe he knows this guy.
Tom Lawrence. I know him, but not very well. Tom was a chemist and he worked in the university. In the order, he studied artifacts, performing chemical analysis on various items. He was always calm, smiling, and not very talkative. I don't know what happened to him. You've seen a ghost for the first time, but more terrible things have happened here. As for the ghost, it's pretty simple. We have to find what binds him to this world and find out why he's been kidnapping the mafia bosses. Once we figure this out, I think we'll be able to discover the link with the missing children. We can't speak with the ghost, but perhaps you'll be able to find something in his office.
Good evening, Miss Stone. I didn't expect to see you so late at night. I'm new here, and this is my first night watch. Everyone's talking about the disappearing gangster and the child who disappeared at the same time. All this makes my skin crawl. I even thought I saw a ghost. Sorry, I didn't want to scare you. If you need me for anything, I'll be in the guards room.
Thank you. Let me tell you how these documents came to me. As usual, on the weekends, I was watching butterflies by the bay. I heard a noise. I turned around and saw a man run out of the woods holding a small folder. He ran past the dried-up well and threw the folder in before running further. A short time later, some men came out of the woods. They surrounded the running man, forced him to his knees, and began to threaten him with weapons. They demanded that he return the papers. The next moment was imprinted permanently on my memory. I heard a shot. It was some time before I could come back here and get the folder from the bottom of the well. There were documents, photographs, and letters inside. There was enough evidence to put down the most dangerous mafioso of our time for good. I realized how dangerous these documents were. I don't trust the police, so I hid the documents here, in my laboratory. Maybe I'm making the wrong choice, but I saw what they did to that man, and I'm afraid. When they came into my possession, I was terrified, and my fears were justified. The day after I found the folder of the evidence, the Mafia came for me. I only vaguely remember what happened. In the end, they tied me up with a chain, hooked it to a rock, and threw me into the water. I remember sinking deeper and deeper, swallowing moss and slime and reaching the bottom. I burned to take vengeance against the monsters who did this to me, and my prayers were answered. An ancient force of nature, the spirit of this place, returned me to life. He made me stronger and far more dangerous. I believe that you will give these papers to the honest policeman. I've let those monsters go, and I believe you'll put them down forever. But I don't know anything about the children. I don't have anything to do with their disappearance. Believe me.
There can be no more doubt that the children were kidnapped by the Mafia. They were a decoy. The Mafia couldn't find out who was looking for them, and no one would have helped them find him. So they came up with a plan. When one of their own was kidnapped, they kidnapped a child. The authorities combined the cases of the kidnapped children and the Mafia bosses and went to work. All the Mafia had to do was watch and wait for the right moment. I'll make sure the evidence gets into the right hands. Believe me, the guilty parties will be punished. For now, keep looking for the children. The note mentioned a meeting at the port. I think it might be worth going there and taking a look. I'll get a keycard ready to take you there through the tunnels.
Thank you. Thanks for helping me. Are you looking for the children? They're in one of the containers in the warehouse. I'm ashamed to say that I took part in the kidnappings. When you work for these people, you don't get a lot of choice. When I raised my objections, they tied me up and wanted to throw me into the water. But then, a green smoke appeared. It surrounded one of the bosses, and when it disappeared, the boss was gone. When I saw this, I lost consciousness, and I don't know what happened next. I think the children are still in the container, but I don't know which one it is.
Thank you. Thank you.
our story comes to an end. The children were saved, and the mafiosi are in a place where they can do no more harm to anyone.